Right, right, okay. Say when.
Dancing, I was 2.5 years old at Dance Arts in Bridgehampton, and my first performance was the Nutcracker. I was a Point Chanel, and then I was an angel.
I ride 5 times a week at Twin Oaks Stables in Bridgehampton. When I was 3, I used to always go to Deep Hollow Ranch in Montauk, and I always wanted to start, and then my mom let me go to pony camp when I was 6, and that's how it started.
I've been playing volleyball for about 5 years, but my parents are both coaches, so I've been in the gym since I was in like diapers, so yeah, a long time.
I started skating when I was 8, was the first time I got on the ice, and I was at a little outdoor rink, and I would only skate in the winter, and then I decided I wanted to keep going and skate all the time, and I started competing when I was 11.
My training schedule is I swim Monday, Wednesday, Fridays are what's called two-a-days. You swim in the morning at 6. I swim in the morning from 6 to 7:30, and then I swim in the afternoon at 2:30 to like 4, and then Tuesday and Thursdays I do dry land for like an hour, hour and a half, before or after, depends on how I feel, and then I have some practice for an hour and a half.
I take classes 4 times a week, and then I usually have rehearsals on Sunday if I have an upcoming show. My classes are 2.5 hours each, and it has an hour and a half of flat without point shoes, and then an hour with point shoes.
I drive an hour each way to get to Hopog to skate at the rinks for usually 2 hours a day, 4 or 5 days a week.
I've always really been with the club team academy. I'm in the gym at least twice a week, and then tournaments on the weekends, so my life really revolves around volleyball.
I realized I wanted to keep skating probably just when I first started, and when I started getting more serious about it and I started working with a coach. And I hadn't really learned the correct way of a lot of technique before then, and when I started working with her, it was really exciting, and had my first competition, and it was just so exciting, I wanted to keep going.
I realized that I was like really enjoyed swimming, that like I could go really far with it. When I won, it's called JOs, which is Junior Olympics, and it was my second year. Yeah, my second year on the team, and I won like the sprint event, the 50, and that was like kind of when I really realized that like I could actually do this and everything.
I never really thought about it, but I just kind of kept dancing, and I really liked it, so I just wanted to continue through high school, even though some people think that's a little weird. I thought it was good to continue with my friends.
After my first horse show, I realized that I didn't want to do anything else, and riding was my main hobby and a passion.
Well, I really was like born into a family playing volleyball, so I've been always in the gym, so I really just came naturally that I wanted to do it.
I haven't really got any pressure from my parents about it. They've been pretty like relaxed about not putting pressure on me, but making sure that I stick to my training schedule and that I still like am focused on what I'm doing because I've dedicated so much time to it.
I can do whatever I want, they say, so not pressure to play the sport, just to work as hard as I can. Both of my parents throughout my volleyball career have been not head coach, but assistant coaching me. And that's really helpful because not only do I have like their support as parents, but they teach me throughout the way. And having them on the sidelines there is like really helpful to me.
I don't think I've ever felt any pressure from my parents. It's mostly just been from me and wanting to make them proud of me, but also just wanting to do my best, compete well.
Tons and tons of money. I couldn't even guess how much money my mom has spent between gas money and hotel money and feeding me, because swimmers can eat, and all the suits that we wear. I mean, our suits alone, like our Fastkins for competitions, are like $400 or more, and I own 4 of them, and I need new ones. So I'd say in the thousands. Like, per year, my mom has put so much into this for me, and I couldn't be more grateful. The amount is just ridiculous.
Over my 15 years of dancing, my parents have probably spent $75,000 for classes and performances, shoes, leotards, tights, and all that stuff probably would amount to $75,000. And it would definitely be, I thought it was definitely worthwhile because I learned, well, starting at a young age, the music and the discipline of ballet really helped me develop as a person. And it really taught me how to use my time and how to learn from a teacher, starting even before I went to school. So I think it was definitely worthwhile for me.
My horse to lease, I lease a horse every year. That's about $12,000 to $15,000 for 6 months. And then board is $3,000 every month. And then horse shows can range from $200 to $2,000 depending on where you are. And overall, I think we've probably spent like $100,000, if not more, throughout the years.
I couldn't even tell you how much it costs altogether, because first there's travel money, and I'm driving 60 miles each way, 4 days a week, so that's pretty expensive. And then dresses are $800 to $1,000 for each, really nice, because I do custom, I have them designed for my music, and then ice time runs about $20 per session, and my coach charges $50 for a half hour lesson, so I have a few lessons per week, so that's pretty expensive.
I have not had any serious injuries. I have a lot of pain, but it's nothing serious. I hurt my hip at one point, but I haven't had to have any medical procedures. My feet always hurt, but I can kind of prevent it with toe pads in my point shoes, and I use a lot of gel and Icy Hot and Band-Aids.
I luckily have not had any serious injuries, but after those 2 weeks when swimming starts back up in September, the pool's cold because they like refilled it and it's all new, and your muscles aren't used to wearing fins, and that's when your feet cramp up. And I've had them so bad where it's felt like I could take the muscle, like I could like lift it up. It was like a brick. It hurt so bad.
I was at a show and the horse and I fell down together, and I was knocked unconscious and I had to get rushed to the hospital, and I didn't remember my name or my birthday. And another time I fell off and I broke my foot and my arm.
No, not really. Well, I broke my toe, but I was at regionals, so I still played, but not really, just broken toe.
I've never had any falling injuries really or anything. I've just had some more long-term injuries. Like, I've had to switch around my skates a lot to find the right boot for my feet because I get really bad cramps and just back problems from all the twisting and landing and bending.
My trainer is Jen Bowery, and I have been with her for 6 years now, and she's awesome. She's pushed me through everything, and I couldn't have done it without her. And I would say, Mom, thank you for coming to every single horse show and not missing anything. I don't think I'm going to be able to ride when I get to college, but when I come home, I'll always have riding part of my life.
I would definitely thank my mom. I know that sounds really lame, but she's the one that taught me to swim. She's the one that has brought me to all the swim meets. She's the one that allowed me to think about moving and switching teams. And then when I didn't move, she's the one that has still coached me, even as an independent, and has put up with me through a ton because she's my mom and my swim coach. And sometimes I don't want to do things she tells me to at practice, and we fight, but she has definitely taught me everything I know. I have been fortunate enough to be recruited by a Division I swimming team, San Diego State, which is amazing because I get to swim outside. But hopefully by swimming for the Division I school, I'll be able to get a lot more training done and get faster and continue to train, and hopefully for Worlds and Olympics, because that's the main goal.
This fall I'm going to the University of Richmond in Richmond, Virginia, and they have a ballet company, and they also have ballet and different dance classes, but I'm not sure if I want to be a member of the company. I'd have to audition, and I want to see what my time at school will be like before I commit to the big ballet company, because I don't know if I'll have enough time.
If I could give thanks to one person, I couldn't pick, because it would be between my coach and my parents, because they have supported me through everything, and skating has been so much learning about the sport, but also a lot of life lessons that I wouldn't be the same without. In the fall, I am going to be skating at Boston University, and they have an intercollegiate team, so we compete with other colleges and universities. And it's team-oriented, which is really exciting because skating all my life has just been very individual and all about me. And now I get to work with other people and have fun with that.
Over winter break, I was invited to go to the USA A1 National Team Training Camp. And it's basically the top 50 kids in, top 58 volleyball players in my age group. And we get together and go for about a week playing just like sessions, and you're getting evaluated, and it's basically a USA pipeline, and so that was really cool, meeting all the people from around the country. I definitely want to play college volleyball, and it's a dream to play D1, and some like my favorite schools would probably be Pepperdine, even though it's far away, and UCLA, Penn State.